So in today's video, I'm going to show you my very own setup for working on logo designs in Adobe Illustrator. And this is my logo setup in 2019. Okay, so firstly, obviously, I'm going to make a new document. And when I'm just starting out my logo design projects, I tend to go for a square canvas. And I'd like to start off by making two artboards, which I will convert into six in a minute, which you're going to see. But of course, there's no bleeds needed because this isn't a print project. And the color mode doesn't matter too much, but let's go with CMYK and then a 300 PPI resolution. And so once I have my two artboards, I then grab the artboard tool, and I do like to separate them just a tiny bit. But then I can actually hold down Shift and then click both of the artboards at the same time, and then hold down the Alt or the Option key to click and duplicate them downwards. I can repeat the process to have six different artboards, and I do this because by default Illustrator doesn't space them out enough for my liking. And what I personally tend to do is I start in the top left with my logo design, and then I kind of evolve that design over to the next and then downward. So once I have my artboard set up, I like to make a few different view options and just come up to view and then create new view. And I'm going to make one view to see the entire artboard selection. And then I'm going to create an individual view for each of the artboards. So I can just then zoom right into a specific design by just coming up to the view options at any time in my projects. I find this is a really fast and a really efficient way to work. So the next step for setting up my document for logo designing is that I can actually rename the artboards if I want to by coming up to here with the artboard tool selected. This isn't essential, but it might help later when we go to export on a mass amount for a web. Now quickly, one crucial thing that I really hate being activated by default, and that is the align to art pixel grid option up here. If you see the icon black, like you can see on my screen, this means it's activated. And for my logo design projects, this is going to cause me all kinds of headaches if it is actually switched on. And to demonstrate how it's going to cause problems, I'm going to make a shape on my artboard. And then watch as I grab the pen tool and try to place a vector point in a specific place. Illustrator is actually snapping the pen tool to each individual pixel placing, which is really, really annoying because nothing can ever be as accurate and as precise as you want it to be. So when I go ahead and turn it off, you can see I can now place my pen tool vector points in any position that I want. So next, for my document in Adobe Illustrator for logo designing, and probably I'm going to need the rulers, so press Command or Control R to open up the rulers. And then I'm going to address the increment nudge settings. Let me explain what that means. So basically, if I've got an object or a design on screen, I can press the up, right, left and down arrows on my keyboard, and this will dictate, you know, where the shape or the design is moved. If the settings are not relevant to your canvas size, your artboard size, then the shape is either going to move too slowly or too fast along your screen. And right now, if I try and nudge this shape, it doesn't move anywhere because the settings are too small, too low. So I can change the preferences in the preference settings, and I can change the increment values to something a bit more higher in value. Command or Control K is the shortcut for the Illustrator preference settings. Now when I move the circle, it moves a lot easier and a lot further along my artboard. The increment settings are going to be completely down to the size of your artboard and also down to just your personal preference. I'm now going to tidy up and arrange my workstation for logo designing. And to begin with, I'm going to remove these options on the side here just to maximize my screen space for designing. Also, I'm going to lessen the spacing in the toolbar. And I really make use of the shape builder tool when I'm logo designing. So I'm going to drag out that panel here so it has easy access whenever I want to use it. And to go along with that, I'm going to grab the Pathfinder window as well, because I do use that a lot too when logo designing. And it's just nice to have them both in the same place, you know, easily accessible. I probably should do this at the end, but just to let you know now, you can actually save this workstation and this setup that you've got to a relevant name. So for example, for me, I could save a Illustrator 2019 workspace for logo designing. Next, another really crucial and important setting for me is the Illustrator Smart Guides. And these are the settings I use here, and this allows me to use Illustrator in a way that I'm perfectly aware when I'm in line and evenly spaced apart from different design assets on my logo design projects. So as you can see, there are magenta lines that appear, letting me know when I am in line with a different point or a different object. Now you can turn these off by pressing Command or Control U on your keyboard, because sometimes you do want to have them when you want to evenly space out objects or make things completely in line in quick real time. But also it can be annoying because sometimes you want to position something in a specific and a precise way that is not in line, and Illustrator will try and fix it in position for you. And we're going to explore yet more preference settings, but this time, let's take a quick look at the user interface. Now, I personally go for the second darkest interface, and let me explain why. If I'm going to be logo designing for quite a long period of time, having the bright interface is really going to mess with my eyes and it's going to give me a headache. But then if you go to the other extreme and go for the completely darker one, I feel the text and the other white elements are too high contrasting to the dark interface. So I like to go for the second most darkest, as it's easy on the eyes, but it's not too contrasting. But yeah, let me know down below, what is your personal preference for the interface? I'm really curious to know what you guys use for your setup in Illustrator. But then moving on from that preference, I've got a different preference setting that is for the anchor points on my design. By default, I don't have them set to the maximum height and I don't have them too small. I do like to have the anchor points easily seen and easily accessible, but I don't want them too big so it kind of crowds my design. So as you can see, they're fairly big, and this is what I'm used to actually, this looks normal to me. I remember when I changed them up for the very first time, I thought it looked huge, but now looking back at it, the smaller ones kind of feel a bit weird. But yeah, again, that's just my preference, and that's why they're called preference settings. So we've nearly set up my Illustrator document for logo designing. But one of the really important things is to have your color swatches ready to apply. Now I typically design a logo in black and white first, but it's just nice to have the colors there if need be. And I personally start off a logo design from Pantone colors from the get-go. Pantone colors are universally recognized and universally known wherever you go into any print shop. So it makes sense to use Pantone colors. You can find them in the swatch library under the color book section. And Pantone Solid Uncoated is usually used for matte designs. You can always use standard colors and then convert the color artwork later, but you will have changes in how it looks. So I personally think it's just, you know, it just makes sense to start using Pantone from the beginning. And I'm gonna lump that over with the other panels here, easily accessible whenever I need them. So yeah, that is my Illustrator setup for logo designing in 2019. Let me know what you think of today's video, but also let me know about your setup and your personal preferences. I find it really interesting that we're all graphic designers, but we all use the same program in a different way. There are probably a few other settings that I've missed, but I can't think of them right now. But yeah, make sure to subscribe to my channel if you want to keep boosting your skills as a graphic designer. And like and share my videos on social media if you do want to help out the channel. Have a great day, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.